The Fulton Supercomputing Lab runs thousands of computing resources to aid in scientific research, mathematical computations, and the pursuit of higher education. These resources are made available to you as a benefit of the university. As of 2012, the supercomputing department houses about 1,000 compute nodes, 10,000 active processing cores, and nearly 24 terabytes of physical memory. These resources are made available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We currently employ 2 full-time system administrators, a part-time hardware technician, and a part-time web developer, who are available to assist and answer questions and ensure the system runs optimally. To access the supercomputer, you need to create an account. Account requests can be made through our website, fsl.byu.edu. Faculty need simply apply. Students must first have a faculty sponsor before given access to an account. As this video progresses, we'll talk briefly on some of the benefits the supercomputer offers, how it differs from a typical desktop machine, and some simple information you might find beneficial on your work with a supercomputer. Let's first discuss a few terms. HPC. HPC stands for High Performance Computing. High performance computing is the use of a large amount of computing resources to complete work quickly and efficiently. Node. A node in terms of HPC is simply a server, an individual computing system with a CPU, memory, and a hard drive. Processor. A processor or CPU is the central computing component of any system. It performs all of the mathematical calculations that make the computer work. Core. Modern processors have multiple cores of execution. For the most part, each core acts like an individual processor. You may have heard the term dual core or quad core processor. Batch job. A batch job is a script submitted by a user that launches a program, such as MATLAB, CFD code, or protein folding programs. Compute node. A compute node is a server on which batch jobs run. Interactive or login nodes. These are used for logging in, moving files around, and submitting batch jobs. They are available through ssh.fsl.byu.edu. So how is the supercomputer different from the machine you're using to watch this video? Imagine trying to move a pile of bricks from one end of campus to the other. Sure, you could complete the task by yourself, but it might take hours, even days, to do so. Now imagine having thousands of people to help. You'd be able to complete the job in a matter of minutes. This is where the supercomputer comes into play. Thousands of resources made available to tackle single or multiple jobs 24 hours a day. The supercomputer, in many ways, is no different than your personal computer. It has a CPU, memory, and a hard drive. The benefit comes with the sheer number of resources made available to you. You may be wondering how to decide between running jobs on a single processor or running jobs on multiple processors. It really comes down to your individual needs, but I'll attempt to explain the differences between the two. Single processor versus multiprocessor jobs. Most problems can be grouped into one of two categories. Scenario 1. The problem can be broken down into small pieces and analyzed independently. The results then get aggregated to solve the problem. For example, if you have a year's worth of data that you need to run calculations on, you could break up the work into days or months. The results would then be aggregated to produce the final result. During the initial processing, no communication is required between the processors doing the work. For example, the processor working on week 3 of January doesn't need to know anything about week 2 of March. This would be a problem suited for single processor jobs, and a lot of them. Scenario 2. The problem can be broken down into smaller pieces, but communication is needed between processors. For example, imagine a jigsaw puzzle. A single person could complete the puzzle, one piece at a time. If you have, say, 3 or 4 people working on the puzzle, you could complete the puzzle in a much shorter amount of time, but they must be able to communicate with each other to get it done. This would be a multiprocessor or multi-node job that uses either threading or an MPI library. It must be noted, working with 4 people on the puzzle versus one person doesn't necessarily mean the puzzle will get done 4 times faster. The same goes for the supercomputer. Running a job on 1,000 processors versus one processor doesn't necessarily mean it will complete 100 times faster. There are an immense amount of resources made available to our users, but as you can imagine, these resources are limited. The problem is, how do you fairly divide resources amongst multiple users? The answer is a scheduler. Resources are managed through our job scheduler. The scheduler's responsibility is to ensure each batch job is treated fairly and that jobs are moving on and off the system in a timely manner. If the system ever reaches max capacity, meaning all of the system's resources are being consumed, the scheduler will create a line or queue for waiting jobs. As resources free up, more jobs will be allowed to run on the system. To learn more about how the job scheduler works, please watch the YouTube video on our channel about schedulers. The entire system runs on Linux. You'll have to know a little Linux to use the system. Not to worry though, when I said a little, I meant a little. We offer tutorials and a cheat sheet on our website with the basic information you need to use the system. If you're not familiar with Linux or Unix, take a few minutes to go over the Unix tutorial on our website. We hope this video has introduced you to the Fulton Supercomputing System, and we encourage you to look at some of the other videos on our YouTube page and review the documentation on our website.